Have you ever seen an ant jump in slow motion? How about this? Did you know when a tiny bug called a springtail jumps, it can do 8 backflips in under 1/40th of a second? My name's Adrian, I'm an entomologist, and I study insect behavior. That springtail that you just watched, it's not technically an insect, but I found it back there on the lid of my trash can, and it was just too cool not to study. If you've never met an entomologist, you're not alone. I hadn't either until I went to college and I met this guy, Professor Walter Schinkel, who happened to study ants. As a student, I started working in his lab doing odd jobs and helping out with field work. Like, this is a picture of me in a 10-foot deep hole I dug to collect a colony of harvester ants. And in the 15 years since that picture was taken, most of my time as a scientist has been spent studying ant behavior and communication. My lab is in the North Carolina Museum of Natural Sciences. It's actually part of the exhibits at the museum. The front wall is glass and visitors can come by and watch us work while we're open. The best part about what I do and what gets me excited to go into the lab every day is that it's my job to try to see and describe something that no one else has before. For me, that means filming a lot of insects. Some of my work ends up published in peer-reviewed scientific papers, but I also put a lot of it onto YouTube on my channel Ant Lab. So I think the best way I can show you what I'm interested in as a scientist is to show you some of my favorite clips and introduce you to some of the creatures that I study. This is a trapjaw ant, and that right there is the tip of my finger. They're famous for doing this. They have a spring-loaded jaw they can snap shut faster than almost any other animal. They've been my main study organism for years. Right now, we're actually working on publishing their genome. The species I study live in Florida, where they use their snapping jaws to do things like catch prey or launch themselves out of a dangerous situation. The snap of their jaw used to be the fastest described animal movement, but a couple years ago, my colleagues and I did a study on these ants, Mystrium camillae, a snapjaw ant from Southeast Asia. They use huge muscles in their head to press the tips of their jaws together, bending them like a spring. And when their jaws slip past each other, the ant releases a lightning-fast jaw strike. To visualize their snaps, we had to film these ants at nearly 500,000 frames per second. These are currently the fastest snapping ants on Earth. More recently, I've been working on other insects, ones that I can find closer to home, and I've been amazed by what we've been able to document with these insects that live right outside my door. For example, this is my friend Matt, who's also an entomologist. He's collecting larval insects feeding off this dead tree right in the middle of our university campus. From that single tree, Matt and I were able to document several new insect behaviors, like this. This is a larval fly, also known as a maggot. It curls its body into a spring and leaps into the air. In this developmental stage, the fly doesn't have legs, so it uses two mouth hooks to latch onto itself, stretch its body, and fling itself away from danger. To identify what species these larvae were, we had to rear them into adults. So this is them first emerging as an adult fly from their larval cocoon. Once they emerge, we were able to identify the jumping maggots as the larval stage of these lance flies. The other amazing jumping thing we pulled from under the bark of that dead tree is this, a larval beetle. We're not quite done with our research on this insect yet, but what I can tell you now is that there's no other insect that we know of that jumps in the same way this beetle does. It's probably a new type of animal movement. As I find new things and make new discoveries, I share them on my YouTube channel, Ant Lab. All the organisms that you saw in this video have their own videos over there. So big thanks to Professor Dave for letting me share these stories with you, and I hope to see you over at the Ant Lab.